All right, 12th class, is the sample paper visible to everyone? All of you, please open a rough notebook in front of you and let us continue with the questions. I think in the last lecture, we finished up till 28th question. We have to start with, 26 we have done. We are to start with 27. Okay. Is the notepad file visible? Yes, class, PDF of the paper and notepad file both are visible. Varun, Anushka. All right. So we are at 27th question. Suppose the content of the myfile.txt is twinkle, twinkle, little star. How I wonder what you are. Up above the world so high, like a diamond in the sky. So this is the question, content of the file. Okay. Am I clear? Now the question is, where the notepad file is gone? Just a minute, please. All right. My file equal to open my file dot txt data my file dot read lines. Print length of data, my file dot close. Now, as per this question, the examiner has given you read lines function. Read lines function is given, and as per the question, the lines are being read from the file. The lines are being read from the file, okay? And the length of data is counted. Each line when read is stored in the variable data. Every line which is read is stored in the variable data, okay? And total lines read are 4. Total lines read are 4. So what will be the length of the data? 4. That is B option. That is B option. Okay. Am I clear? Moving to 28th question. Identify the output of the following Python statements. Identify the output of the following Python statements. Now here X is having two nested lists. First nested list is 10.0, 11.0, 12.0. Second is 13.0. 14.0, 15.0. Okay. This is having index 0. This is having index 1. Now these two are already list. ये दोनों अपने आप में लिस्ट है, सो दैट मीन्स दे विल बी फर्दर डिवाइडेड 0, 1, 2 एंड दिस विल बी ऑल्सो 0, 1, 2 ओके. नाउ एग्जामिनर इज आस्किंग एक्स ऑफ वन ऑफ टू, एक्स ऑफ वन, एक्स ऑफ वन ऑफ टू, द फर्स्ट एलिमेंट ऑफ एक्स दैट इज दिस एलिमेंट, फर्दर इट्स सेकेंड सब एलिमेंट, सेकेंड सब एलिमेंट इज 15, सो इट इज 15.0. सो एज पर द गिवन ऑप्शंस, डी ऑप्शन इज द मोस्ट सुटेबल वन. क्लियर ऑल ऑफ यू ऑनलाइन क्लास? एम आई क्लियर अप टिल हेयर? यस ऑनलाइन क्लास, गिव योर फीडबैक फास्ट. All right. Moving to 29th question. Identify the output of following Python statements. X equal to 2 while X less than 9. That is 2, 3, 4 till 8. Less than 9 means it will start from 2, it will go till 8. Okay. Print X. First time X will be 2, then X will be 3, then X will be 4, then 5, then 6, then 7, then 8. Because every time the value of X is printed and X is incremented by 1. Whenever we will use while loop ke features sun lijiye. While loop has three features. Initialization outside. This is the loop variable. X is loop variable. Initialization outside. Testing condition. Along with while and update of looping variable inside the body of loop. Okay, so appropriate option is C. C option is the most suitable option. C option is the most suitable option. Am I clear? Now moving further. 30th question. B equal to 1 for A in range 1, 10, 2. 1, 10, 2. This is the lower limit. This is the upper limit. And this is the number of steps. Third value is the number of steps with which you are to move. Okay. So as per the loop, we will have values 1. Then after 1, you will be having 3. After 3, 5. Then 7. Then 9. Okay. These will be the values of A variable. And A is looping variable. Okay. Am I clear? Then coming inside the loop, starting with the first value 1. Hum loop ke andar aa gaye. Loop ke andar aake B equal to A plus 2. B plus equal to A plus 2. It means B equal to B plus A plus 2. So what is the value of B First time 1, it is given here, value of B is 1. First time value of A is also 1, that we have checked from here, plus 2. So B becomes 4. B becomes 4. In the next iteration, A will be 3, B will be 4. So it becomes 4 plus 3 plus 1. So 2, sorry. So it has become 9. B is 9. Okay. Then in the third iteration, B equal to B plus A plus 2, B will be 9, A will be 5. Check the value of A from here. 5 plus 2. So B will be 9 plus 4. This is 16. Okay. Then in the next iteration, B will be 16. A will be 7. And it will be 2. So B becomes 23 plus 2. 25. 25. Okay. So for the last iteration, B will be 25. A will be 9. And 2 added. So B becomes 36. B becomes 36. And as per our answer, उसके बाद loop fail हो गया. After this 9 value, the for loop fails. So our answer is 36. Print B 36. So as per 36, our answer is C option. Am I clear? Online class? Nia, Sukmani, Jatin, am I clear with the concept? Sadev, Manreet, Gagan, Gaurav. Yes, I have to keep that pass. All right. Moving to 31st question. 31st question. Now here, see carefully. We have been given a list 10, 15, 20, 25, 30. और इसकी इंडेक्सिंग है 0, 1, 2, 3 और 4. Okay? Am I clear? Then we are having list dot insert 3, 4. Insert function of the list signifies that at this particular index, insert this element. First value is the index. Second value is the value which you are to store at that index. What is lying at index 3 already? Index 3 pe pehle se kya padha hua hai? 25. Now it will be 4. So new list has become 10, 15, 20, 4, 25, and 30. This is the new list. Then you will add index 3. This is index 3. Value was 25. Now, as per the insert function, third index, store the value 4. That is what we have done. When you have stored the new value at the given index, shift to the right. Next, rest of the element, shift to the right. Okay? Now, second statement. List dot insert 2, 3. List dot insert 2, 3. It means at index 2, we are to store the variable 3. So at index 2, 10, 15, 3, 20, 4, 25, 30. This is the new list. Okay. Am I clear? Now, last statement is print the value which is lying at -5. -5 means backward indexing. Starting from here, -1, -2, this is -3, this is -4, this is -5. So what is lying at -5? 3. So our option matches with 3. B option. So B option is the suitable one. Am I clear, online class? 31st question is clear. Varun, Anushka. Arun Chauhan, 39, roll number. Are you attending the class or not? All right. Now moving to the 32nd question. Raghav is trying to write a tuple. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 on a binary file test.bin. Consider the following code by him. Tuple 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Tuple ek sequence ho gaya. Sequence which is written to the file. Okay. Am I clear? File open key test.bin and we open the file in WB mode. Now we are to store this tuple, this sequence in the binary file. To write the data, we need dump function of pickle module. Okay. So what is the correct syntax which is to be come in the blank here? Pickle dot dump. The name of the sequence comes first, then comes file handle. And what is the name of the file handle? My file. The name of the file handle is my file. It is given here in the question when the file is opened in the write mode. Am I clear? So as per this answer, our B option is correct. Okay. This is 32nd question. Now I am moving to 33rd question. A binary file employee.data.dat has the following data. और ये एक display function लिया हुआ है, and inside this display function employee number has been passed as parameter, and the file has been opened in read mode. File is opened in read binary mode. Okay, and ENO is parameter of employee E code, which is to be searched. Okay, so ye wala sara function usne lagaya. R of 0 means pehli field. Pehli field kya hai? इंप्लॉय नंबर, आर ऑफ वन क्या होगा इंप्लॉय नेम, आर ऑफ टू क्या होगा सैलरी. सो ही इज फाइंडिंग टोटल ऑफ द सैलरी, टोटल ऑफ द सैलरी. ओके, when the above mentioned function display 103 is executed, the output display is 190,000. Write appropriate jump statement from the following to obtain the above output. इनमें से कौन सी suitable jump statement है जिसको हम लगाएं और हमारा आउटपुट आ जाए. वी कैन नॉट यूज, देखो जंप कोई स्टेटमेंट नहीं है, हमारे पास है ब्रेक और कॉन्टिन्यू, ब्रेक और कॉन्टिन्यू. अगर हम ब्रेक लगाएंगे, इफ वी विल अप्लाई ब्रेक, इट विल कम आउट ऑफ द बॉडी, इट विल कम आउट ऑफ द लूप बॉडी, तो दिस विल नॉट सर्व आवर पर्पस. कॉन्टिन्यू, कॉन्टिन्यू इज ऑल्सो अ जंपिंग स्टेटमेंट. कॉन्टिन्यू सेज स्किप, skip the part of code and continue with the next iteration. So C option is the most suitable option. मान लीजिए पहला employee number match नहीं करता तो वो अगले employee number को check करेगा, अगर अगला match नहीं कर रहा तो वो third employee number को match करेगा. That is why we have used continue, that it will not come out of the loop, it will continue with the next iteration. Okay, am I clear to all? Now moving to 34th question. All right, now as per 34th question, what will be the output of the Python code? The code is, we have been given one add function, and in the add function there are two parameters, number one, number two, number one, number two. Okay, then we have to find the sum of two numbers and store the result in the sum variable. We will start our execution from here. हमने फंक्शन कॉल किया 20 और 30 लेके, 20 किसको गया नंबर वन को, 30 हैज गॉन टू नंबर टू. व्हेन वी गो, और हम फंक्शन में चले गए, वी वेंट टू द फंक्शन, एट फंक्शन डेफिनेशन वी एड द टू नंबर्स एंड रिजल्ट इज 50. But see carefully inside the function, we are not returning back any value. To the caller function. When we are not turning back, तो यहां पे क्या स्टोर होगा, ये जो स्टेटमेंट है हमने कोई वैल्यू रिटर्न नहीं की तो यहां पे क्या स्टोर होगा, यहां पे स्टोर होगा नन. रिमेंबर नॉन फ्रूटफुल फंक्शन. If no value is returned by the function definition back to the caller function, it will always store the none value. क्योंकि यहां से हमने कोई value return नहीं की, अगर value return करते तो 50 return होता, but we have not used the return statement. So here when you call the function, यहां पर कोई value store होनी है, वैल्यू रिटर्न होके कोई आई नहीं तो वी विल बी स्टोरिंग नन हियर. ओके, एम आई क्लियर विद 34th क्वेश्चन. नाउ मूविंग टू 35th. 16 minus 4 plus 2 into 5 plus 2 into 3 into 4. It becomes 16 minus, solve the bracketed portion, solve the bracketed portion, 6 into 5 plus 2 power 3. 2 power 3 is 8. 8 into 4. 8 into 4. So it becomes 16 minus 30 plus 32. Finally, it becomes 48 minus 30. So answer is 18. And that is our C option. Am I clear? सबसे पहले हमने ब्रैकेट को सॉल्व किया. After solving the bracket, we solve this power, exponent power. Okay. Then we get this result. Adding the positive numbers, subtracting the negative number. Okay, and we get 18 as the result. Am I clear, online class? Now, 36th question is very important. Carefully see. Start from the statement here. Start from the statement, we are to solve 36 question. Start from this statement. Oh, where the notepad file has gone again here. Okay. Print my function with the value 50, comma, my function. Print function के अंदर दो बार function call किया हुआ है. See the twist in the question. Inside the print function, we have called the function twice. First time we call by giving value 50. Second time we call without giving any value. So what, how it will execute? Sabse pehle ye wala function call hoga 50 value ke saath. 50 kisko jayegi? Variable 1. They have given default values 100. These are the default values. Now we have called this function. First time ye wala function call hoga 50 ke saath, to 50 chali gayi variable 1 ko, and variable 2 will be having value 200. So come inside the function, variable 1 plus equal to 10, 50 plus equal to 10, it is 60. Then variable 2 equal to variable 2 minus 10, that is 200 minus 10, it is 190. Finally, return variable 1 plus variable 2, that is 60 plus 190, it is 250. So first answer which is returned here, yahi pe call hua hai, yahi pe print ho jana hai. So first answer kya print hoga? 250. Okay, Now, second time, we call this function without any parameter. When you call the function without any parameter, it will take the default values. It will take the default values. So it will be 100 plus 10, 110, and 200 minus 10 is 190. So it is 110 plus 190, it is 300, right? So next time it will return 300. So our D option is suitable. Okay, am I clear to all?